thank you for your company on this Saturday morning. Well, National Cabinet has held crucial talks on ending Australia's lockdowns. The key, no surprise, getting jabs in arms. More under 60s are giving AstraZeneca a shot. New research showing 65,000 young Australians got the jab since the Prime Minister said this.
If you wish to get the AstraZeneca vaccine, then we would encourage you to A, go and have that discussion with your GP.
4 weeks on, a helpful boost to our immunisation program. But jab hesitancy is still rife. In New South Wales, one in five over 70 are yet to have a single dose of vaccine. That's despite the state recording daily case numbers in the hundreds and its biggest city entering day 35 of lockdown. The chances of dying from an AstraZeneca vaccine-associated clot are quite literally one in a million. Let's put that into perspective. The risk of dying from Viagra is 1 in 20,000. Spend too much time in the sun? 1 in about 8,000 will die of heat stroke. And the scariest stat of all? If you're living in Sydney right now, you currently have a 1 in 300 chance of dying if you contract COVID.
Well, for more on this, we're joined by the CSIRO's Health Director, Dr. Rob Granfell, in regional Victoria. Good morning, Rob. The PM has revealed a roadmap out under the plan. Snap lockdowns will be used until 70% of the eligible population is vaccinated. Right now, we're sitting around 18%. So how long will it take to get to that 70%?
Yeah, look, that's a challenging question to answer. But good morning to you all, and certainly thoughts out to everyone in Sydney. It's a shocking thing to be locked down. The time to actually get to that will rely on a number of things. One is supply of vaccine, which has been certainly challenging for, well, everybody globally and certainly here in Australia. The second is actually getting people into the immunisation centres through that sequential way that we're actually doing that. So a lot of people are actually having a bit of hesitancy with regards to getting vaccinated, and also some people are having challenges getting to vaccination centres. So those things need to be ironed out for us to reach the 70%. So again, it's a magical figure. I don't know how long it will take us to get to that point. Again, just consider that there are a lot of people going back for their second dose, and anybody who's up for their second dose, particularly of the AstraZeneca, please get that. And we will see a jump as more and more people are getting that second dose.
Yeah, Rob, no crystal ball here, but how much longer do you think Sydney could be locked down if people continue, you know, to wait for Pfizer?
Yeah, look, that's the only way out of this lockdowning situation that we're having across the country is for more and more people to get vaccinated, because that means there's less chance of the virus circulating at such high levels. At the moment, I would certainly be picking that longer than the 4 weeks, and that's a bad thing to say, I guess, but we are seeing encouraging signs that the rates of new infections are actually decreasing, and that's the important thing. The lockdowns are working, but they will have to continue if people keep moving around.
Rob, the target for international border reopening is 80% double dose vaccinated. If the vaccine isn't mandatory, do you think that's possible?
Yeah, look, I'd rather turn that around to say that if everybody in Australia who wants to be vaccinated has been given the opportunity to be fully vaccinated, that's the time that we should move on that. It's been extremely hard to get even our childhood schedules up into the high 90%. We have been the envy of the world with having so many of our childhood immunisations up in the high 90%. But to achieve an 80% is going to be an actual Herculean task. Yes, we could do it. But in one sense, it's a matter of how long it would take.
America has plateaued at around about 50%. What are other countries aiming for?
Yeah, look, again, if we think about, say, countries like the UK or the US, what they're seeing is a rapid increase of this Delta strain, which is really very infectious and ripping through the populations that have not been vaccinated. Now, what's the encouraging sign is that all those high-risk groups, say in the UK, for instance, many people over 75, and we're talking up into the 70 or 80% over in that age group are actually vaccinated. So the hospitalisation and the death rates are not rising as much as they did with the first big waves that went through those areas. Now, what's happening is that many people in, say, the US are getting a little irritated by the fact that others are not immunised or vaccinated and potentially putting them or their loved ones at risk of actually catching the disease. So there is this, you know, I've had it and you haven't had it, that's starting in some of these countries. And then there's those, obviously, people who are completely opposed to vaccination, which are actually making it a little tough for everyone else.
We've seen overseas places like France, people who aren't vaccinated banned from cafes and restaurants and museums. Do you think that would encourage people here if we brought in those kind of rules to get the jab?
Well, again, we're seeing movement around the world of the idea of a so-called vaccine passport. Now, we in Australia obviously are lucky through once you have been vaccinated, you will get a certificate on My Health Record, and that will be on your smartphone. But you need a smartphone to have that record and access to your My Health Record. Now, irrespective of that, we're seeing the idea, say, in international travel and others, if you've got this passport, that allows you privileged access into certain points. Now, that will restrict the spread of the virus. It will not stop it, but it will certainly reduce it. On the other side of it is many international borders will not allow people to pass if they haven't been fully vaccinated for the virus. So that's just going to become a matter of course. That will, again, restrict the passage or the spread of the virus across, say, the borders and things like that.
Mm. OK, Rob, thank you for your time this morning. Rob.